So they did not come.
Rotarian presidents, fellow Rotarians, I have no friend and I have no guest. I've been called to give a brief of what happened, or give a report of our seminar that was conducted last week, that is Friday and Saturday last week. Unfortunately, I arrived the venue very late because I left Bonilla very late, about 2:30. I got to that place about 4 o'clock or so. So I didn't actually follow up for Friday, but for Saturday, I wouldn't want to say the things that have been said by our IPSEC. But I just want to say that one of the things that was said in that meeting or in that seminar that day, especially on Saturday, was for the need for us to meet our Rotarians, those ones who have not been coming for a while. Like, it would be unfair for us to just push them aside, that from time to time, we'll be able to talk to them. It's not every now and then we'll begin to ask them about payments, you know, club use and all that. First of all, find out how they are faring. Find out what has happened to them in the past. For them not to have been coming to fellowship, you find out what happened before you now begin to ask them about fees or about dues. And of course, they talked about grants, how we can get grants. And like she said, as a club, if you don't put into the grants, if you don't donate as a club, you cannot get. Now, one striking thing that Mrs. Pearl Idoma said was the need for us to tell some persons about what they need to do, because a lot of us feel that once you get Buharis, once you become a Buharis fellow, it's the highest in Rotary, the highest donation one can give in Rotary. But the woman gave a narrative of what happened to between her and Chris, you know, our present minister of productivity, labor and productivity. That a man was invited to Tobacco by, I think, Tobacco Central. And say what?
From
Abuja, yes. And he was to be given an award, a pin, you know, as for Harris Fellow. Now, when it was Pearl Idoma who was to present that lapel to him, so when she came, she now made it so big, she now told him that, look, it's unfortunate that people didn't tell me the truth, that for Harris Fellow is not the highest donation you make in Rotary, that there are mega donors, there are other things you need to get or you need to do, there are other payments that you need to give to Rotary. And the man was like, give me this thing, now why not? She said, no, I won't give to you, except you come back again to get this major or this mega donation to pay. So she said
that this one is too small.
This one is too small for you, that the kind of person you are, I mean, $1,000 is too much, or sorry, it's too small for you. So 1 year after, Indigo came back to Butako to receive that award. Now what she's saying is that in our approach, you know, why we talk to people or why we try to bring members into our club, we don't just tell them, one particular thing. We don't just narrow our statements or our ideas, the ideas of Rotary to them. We make it wide, we make it open, we tell them, you know, give them allowance for other things so that they now have a choice to choose. For instance, if she has not told that, look, there's a position for mega donor, the man would have just taken it as $1,000 is enough for me, $360,000 against the hedge, you know, is the highest. But because she mentioned the fact that there are other things to benefit, the man now has to come back 1 year after. He may not have gotten that money at that time, but it took some time, and then 1 year, 12 months after, he came back to the back to get that same thing. That's one. Again, I was fortunate to see some friends. From the event to where we slept, I met one Omobo, you know, who happened to be the president-elect. I also met Nkotaria, another president, Victor Nkotaria, another president-elect. If not for my meeting, or if not for my attending that seminar, I mean on Friday, I'm sure that these two friends, because as I came back, I've been able to interact with them, and I see them as good friends. If you don't go out, you want to think that here, Bonny, I mean, it's just, I mean, let us spread our wings more than or beyond Bonny. Because for those of us who are Rotarians, we feel that Staying here in Bonny is enough for us. Whereas it's not so. And again, I was reminded, and I think that too was said to me by the DG. The DG asked us, what exactly is happening in Accra? Why have we not been doing, you know, projects and all that? And of course, I told her the truth. I said, look, we are just few. We were in our numbers initially when we started, when this club was started, we were like 20, 30 something, I think, by the period. But after a while, some persons were delisted. And like our IPSEC said, it is not enough to be this person. Sometimes you give them some time. Yes, we pay the dues in Rotary International. For you not to delete them, it means that you have to pay their dues. But sometimes you give them time. Something may have happened for them not to have paid. I'll give you a scenario. I met one of us, I won't want to call his name. That guy, as far as I know, is an Akaga protractor. And probably would have been a rotator because his elder brother is now a rotator, courtesy of him. If he can make his elder brother, not just one, two of his elder brothers to become rotarians, then he too can be a rotarian. But he said that the only call he receives from one of us each time that call comes in is about dues. That call doesn't ask him, oh boy, how have you been faring? What is it that you're doing today? What have you done before today and all that? The call that constantly comes into or that rings through his phone is always, why? Won't you pay your dues and all that? And he said at the point, he got angry and felt like not picking that call again. And his mind was disabused, even though he was a retractor, because the constant calls he kept getting at a point was money, money, money. He decided not to join Rotary. I've been talking to him, and I know that over time, he will have to change his mind to come. So, he will change his mind and then come back. But please, for us, incoming board of directors, we have gone, we have learned, and with special appearance to our president nominee, who for some time now, by my last count, for the past 3 years, I've not seen him in fellowship. But I'm very, and it's my son, though.
Not correct.
It's my son.
Not past 3 years.
It's my son. Correct. So, with special adherence that is around, so I'm sure that most of this information that has been given now is hearing, and I know that he's going to come in newly because from what he told me last time, he said he's already born again. For him to be a born again, I know that. So many things will begin to happen because born again is not born again from out. There are a lot of things that born again do. And I know
SAA, take note.
One of the things that he's going to do now, one of the things he's going to do is to be coming to fellowship regularly and then to be paying his tuition. Of course, I know he's a very good Rotarian. In fact, he told me that after fellowship, maybe by next month, he'll be hosting us in his house. And I want to believe that after.
Have I even been like this?
No, now, but you said after fellowship, next month, you host us. So you can see that already what we have been told or what we have been taught in front of our people is beginning to, you know. Yeah, it is beginning to manifest. So, Mr. President, I want to end it by saying that I enjoyed my stay in Port Harcourt. If not for anything, I had the privilege of sleeping with the president. It's not easy.
14 years old, you slept with the president. Are you sure?
Sleeping in his house. The
president
is left.
Sleeping in his house.
I'm
sleeping in his house.
I'm giving my own.
You said sleeping with the president.
Okay, in his house. Thank you. And I got two good friends. I said this to, I called the others. I said, one is Victor Nkotaria. That man, single-handedly, for 2 days, was the one taking us to and fro our venue. Another one is President-elect Omobo Douglas. That same person Buma. Too.
Buma Omobo Douglas.
Okay, Buma Omobo Douglas. On Friday, if not for him, I'm sure that locating the venue where we had our get-together would have been a bit difficult. Because...
Okay.
So we met good Rotarians who took time to show us love and care. And that's why we say each time we meet here as Rotarians, we should try and show love to ourselves and then leave Bonny be. Are we together?
Yes.
That each time we meet here, let's be reminded of the fact that we are Rotarians. And our Rotary journey does not end here anymore. exceeds this place. So once we have that slight opportunity to meet elsewhere, like we had in Tobago, let's make ourselves available. Thank you.